4 hours before atomic bombing, I left Nagasaki by train to visit my mother, who had been sick in hospital of the next prefecture. That afternoon, the radio announced that a new type of bomb had been dropped on Nagasaki City. That evening, I took the train again to return to Nagasaki. However, on the back way, the railroad ceased operating and it wasn't arrive until next early morning. I hurried to the hospital because I was a medical student there. The basement of the hospital was filled with groans of many injured people. So we tried to give the first aid to them in that day, that until rescue corps arrived from outside. But the effective medicine ran out quickly, and one by one, people lost their lives. So there was nothing we could do but take the pulse of dying people, and in the final stage of these people, given them water. So for a week, I was busy to stay here in the ruins, and we watched many people was dying without trauma, but hemorrhagic diarrhea and other symptoms. It may be due to the acute radiation injuries. That's right. So my elder brother and his wife and his daughter and boy all died. But I fortunately left from Nagasaki. まあ、複雑なんですけども、そのもちろん自分の家族を失っただけじゃなくてね、その多数の一般市民の人の死をずっと見てたもんですから、やはりこうそれはもう自分にとって忘れがたい、まあ、非常につらい出来事なんですね。だけど一方ではですね、やはり医学生としてある程度まで冷静にね、こういった負傷者がどうしてこんなふうな症状になって死んでいくのかとかっていうことをですね、常に考えながら、まあ、お薬は不足しているからほとんど治療できませんけれども、自分なりにその原因をですね、片方ではこう考えていたということがあるんですね。だから振り返ってみたら、こうしてその原爆投下の問題を考えるときにはですね、やはりそのフィーリングということと、片方では非常にまあ理性的に考えるということがね、その後の僕のまあこう身についたことなので、遡っていくとその当時のね、自分が感じたことがそのままその後も生きているのかなという感じがいたしますけどね。つまり、もう主観的に、あるいは非常に感情的にだけのめり込むんじゃなくて、片方では常にそれをやっぱりね、冷静に判断する、観察するという二面がね、一緒の答えの自分という答えの中に育ったような感じがしますけどね。